Hey, what's going on, guys? Kid from Sunset Park. I'm back bringing you some more Modern Warfare 3 gameplay slash commentary here on the map Hard Hat. I'm using the ACR with the suppressor and the extended mags. And first off, guys, I want to just wish my grandpa a happy birthday. He's 80 today. So if you guys want to spam the comment section saying happy birthday, I'll show it to him. And I'm sure he'll be much appreciated. So besides his birthday, I want to bring you guys some Black Ops 2 information. I know I haven't done a video in a while. I had a nice like five, seven, six day break. I was at my cousin's house and I didn't upload yesterday or whenever you're watching this, 2 days ago, because I didn't have a video ready. So in this video, I want to cover some stuff that's pretty, not old, but stuff you may know already and stuff you may not know that just came out today. So there is a 60-second gameplay footage from GamesCon, which is in Germany. It's a gaming event that I'm going to put a link in the description. They show you what's going on with Black Ops 2, some gameplay footage of it. It's a 60-second thing, so you guys can go check that out. It'll be a link in the description. Also, Black Ops 2, if you didn't hear already, they're going to have a skill-based matchmaking system, which basically means, what I am interpreting it, is it's going to be based on maybe KD ratio, maybe prestige level. But if you think about it, even the bad players in this game could get to a high prestige if they play enough. So I think it's going to be more along the lines of wins or kills or something along the lines of you having, more skill than another player. So they're also going to be breaking up the matchmaking into a ranking system where you can, I'm not too sure how it works. I'm not really too clear on the ranking system that they're going to use, but I know they're going to be bringing that in. I hope it's going to be in a playlist because I still love pub stomping kids. If you see in this game right now, I'm going to be pub stomping these kids. I go absolutely ham on them and it's insane. We had them in a spawn trap, the whole deal, which I hope they still have in Black Ops 2, because, you know, everyone likes that good game where you get into and you break 50 kills, or, you know, you go super duper crazy ham and you break 100 kills, which happened to me in Black Ops a couple of times, where I broke a couple of 100 kills, like 2-3 games. But, you know, everyone likes that, that moment where you could go and just crush the enemy team and just absolutely decimate them, which is pretty awesome, which I hope they don't get rid of, because that's the thing that Call of Duty, it's so traditional, the Christmas noobs, you know, everyone loves playing against them, everyone loves, you know, having your friend who's a low level be the host of the lobby, so you get into, like, low level games, and you just absolutely crush them. Everyone loves that. That's something that Call of Duty kind of based itself on. That's like a tradition in Call of Duty, and I don't think they're gonna get rid of that, but I think they're gonna have another playlist where you could go in with a 6-man team and play some, you know, elite teams, like, teams that are really, really good, that don't want a pub stomp right there, or right now, or they want to go into that, like, team-based, playlist, and, you know, get their money's worth, and, like, you know, see how good they are compared to some of the other players that they're going against, which I won't mind playing at all either, because playing against some elite players to see how good I am compared to them, that'd be something interesting. Another thing that I kind of want to, tell you about, it just came out, I found this information today, I just found it out, Ghost is going to be returning to Black Ops 2, but they said that Ghost is going to be returning, but if a player does not continuously move, he'll show up on the radar as a red dot. And finally, what I've been begging for and waiting for throughout every single Call of Duty, Ghost only makes you invisible from the UAV. No more of that bullshit where you can, you know, your red dot or your red name turns invisible, or you're invisible to EMPs, like in this game, invisible to counter UAVs, shit like that. They're going to make it where you're only invisible to the UAV, just like it's supposed to be, just like COD 4 and World at War. I'm pretty sure they had that, a perk like that, that UAV jammer. Something just like that. Perfect. It can't get any more, you know, satisfying for me as a Call of Duty player to just see that, you know, Ghost, a perk that people are so used to, and I can't wait to the, you know, the kids that relied on Ghost so much in Black Ops 1, they're going to be totally thrown off guard when they see this perk at them. They're going to be putting it on, praying that it's the same thing, and I can't wait to see them constantly on the red dot, on the radar, because they just don't move from their corner and know exactly where they are. That'd be the ultimate, ultimate treat. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section. If you use Ghost, tell me if you think this is a little bit, you know, too extreme, trying to get rid of campers. I think it's just the perfect way to, you know, change the Call of Duty community. It's, you know, a great way to, you know, make sure that these campers and the Ghost users, they don't overrun the game as they did in Black Ops 1, which was kind of a huge downfall for Black Ops 1. If I say so myself, you know, it was one of those things, like one of those perks that kind of everyone used until they came out with the Express playlist, which, you know, was great. But, you know, Ghost really took over the game for the beginning half of it, which kind of pissed me off. Ghost was a really, really annoying perk to deal with, even though I used it. You saw that fail grenade there, too. I had to tell you about that. That's really weird. I didn't know I couldn't throw through the metal brackets or metal bars, but I can shoot through them. Something that Call of Duty needs to change, being able to shoot through metal fences, throw grenades through metal fences, because, you know, that doesn't work either. You can't throw a grenade through a fence, like, or shoot through it. It'll just ricochet back, which is really, really weird. But yeah, Black Ops 2 is looking amazing for me. I cannot wait for it to hit the shelves. Tomorrow, actually, is the day. I completely forgot. Tomorrow, they might be showing some live stream multiplayer from GamesCon, and I will be watching that all tomorrow. If it's true, I'll put a link in the description to the live stream where they're gonna show it. And just stay tuned tomorrow. If they don't show it, you know, that sucks, because I heard a lot of rumors, a lot of little birdies been telling me that they're going to be showing some Black Ops 2 multiplayer footage. I cannot wait, so guys. So stay tuned for that. Enjoy the rest of your week. Just, I'm praying Black Ops 2 is going to be the game that everyone's saying it's going to be. Kid from Sunset Park, let's all just pray for Black Ops 2. I'm out. Peace. Boy, I knew my shit was on another level when people would joke around and say I signed with the devil. Cause it's gotta be a sin to be this good. Hating on my music, shit, I wish you would. Yeah, I've been offered 4 or 5 deals. Bust like banana clips, boy, that's 4 or 5 kills. Doing the most, accumulating so much bread, I think it's time for toast. And I ain't talking fine wine, I'm talking semi-automatic shit that blow your mind. And when I blow like mine, the whole world gon' see me shine. This is the life that I should live, homie, I'm never going back. I'm addicted to the game, y'all can tell by the tracks. Showing pops of rhyme, knocking those times. Showing pops of rhyme, knocking those times. Showing pops of rhyme. I'ma come through and show my wood climb. Knocking those times. Showing pops of rhyme, knocking those times. Showing pops of rhyme.